How's the show so far?
It's going pretty good. I just got here. It's my first year being at Autorama.
All right.
So far, so good.
Oh, me.
Hi.
Will you leave your boyfriend home?
How's it going?
Asked the girl what she wanted to be. She said, baby, can't you see? I want to be famous, a star on the screen. But you can do something in between. Baby, you can drive my car. Yes, I'm gonna be a star. Baby, you can drive my car. And baby, I love you. I told that girl that my prospects were good. And she said, baby, it's understood. Working for peanuts is all very fine, but I can show you a better.
Oh, this is Speed Cult. Speed Cult Detroit. It's just our metal work here.
How long have you been making these?
We've been doing this since 1997, so we've been doing it a long time. Been at Autorama since 1999.
Little step, you don't know, you don't know. Slip, daddy. And coming off the line when the light turns green. Well, she blows him out of the water like you never seen. I get pushed out of shape and it's hard to steer. When I get rubber in all four gears, she's my little loose coop. You don't know what I got.
I built this for my wife, 57 Chip.
She looks very happy with it.
Yeah, so it's our wedding colors, so that's the color of our wedding, so, and that, so it took us 4 years to build it and put it together.
Wow, beautiful job.
Yeah, thank you.
I love it. Reminds me of the love of God. It actually, our 40th wedding, we finished it August 3rd, and our 40th wedding anniversary.
Oh, that's so nice.
It was November 3rd.
Welcome to Autorama.
That is a Myers-Max SR2. That car was originally conceived by Bruce Myers, who was the father of the dune buggy.
Over there.
Yeah. Bruce Myers had originated the tub-style dune buggy, and after he started building them, he really didn't think about the need to patent the idea, so he didn't. And people stole the idea. And eventually, he decided he was going to create something that people couldn't copy as easily that he could patent. And this is the car he created.
Oh, cool.
It's designed by Stuart Reed from the Center of Art and Design in Pasadena. And it's based on a Volkswagen chassis. It's got a 1600cc Volkswagen Beetle engine, 67 Beetle transaxle that's been updated, modified for strength. So it's a very fun project. We started building it in the 70s. It sat for 35 years outside in a field, and then after that, my brother decided he wanted to put it back on the road, and we had to start all over again. But the body has the original fiberglass gel coat.
It's the only one, right?
No, actually, there's a bunch of these. There's probably about 200 of them.
Really?
A number of them in the world.
Cruising down the highway, full moon shining down. Looking out the window, no one else around. Well, Lord have mercy, I pushed that pedal down. What'll this old Ford do? Maybe 100, maybe 102. I had no way of knowing this old.
This is a replica of a 1965 Cobra. It's from Factory 5. It's a Mark IV, which is their newest version. This particular one has been driven two seasons. It's got about 4,000 miles on it. It's here in the Ford booth because it's got a Ford Coyote motor and some whole raft of other Ford parts in it.
I'm cruising in my Corvette. 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 I fly first class in my Corvette, yeah. Yep. I'm cruising in my Corvette with the key top down. I'm cruising in my Corvette with the key top down. I got my left foot on the gas, gonna blow this town. I'm cruising in my Corvette. I'm cruising in my Corvette, making time stand still. Yeah, just 18, that's how I feel. I'm cruising in my Corvette. I'm cruising in my Corvette. I'm cruising in my Corvette. I'm cruising in my Corvette.
Project started a year and a half ago. September 2017, we tried to start this project. It was just basically presented to students. I had an idea. I've always been a motorhead. And I said to the kids, I said, hey, you know, what would be a great idea if we build this Munsters vehicle? And they're like, looking at me like, Munsters, what's that? And I, so I showed them pictures of the Munsters. And I said, this is what I used to watch when I was a kid coming home on TV. And I said, Grandpa Munster built this Dragula. I said, we can build one of these here. I said, I've always wanted to do it. Let's try it. So they're like, okay, what does it look like? So we gave them all the pictures, what it looked like. I drew it out on the chalkboard with some chalkboard drawings, and I'm not an artist. And then we set it up on the floor with tape on the floor and set an engine as a mock-up and the axle and laid everything down. And once we had it all laid out, they got a rough idea how it went together. Then I had the wood shop. They made the outer perimeter so we could look, see what it looks like, so they could get a good idea. And then from there, we just, I gave them some measurements and they started going. And here it is now after a year and a half. I'm so proud. I cannot believe that the kids got to this level with dedication, their enthusiasm. Just, it's a proud moment.
How do you like the show?
It's pretty cool. Mostly I'm here looking around like scavenging for my dad to see like rat rods and hot rods. So taking pictures.
Must be a good man.
Yeah, for
Are
sure.
you a student here again?
Yeah, I'm a senior in high school.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Well, good luck.
Well, I left Kentucky back in 49 and went to Detroit working on assembly line. The first year they had me putting wheels on Cadillacs. Every day I'd watch them beauties roll by, and sometimes I'd hang my head and cry, 'cause I always wanted me one that was long and black. One day I devised myself a plan that should be the envy of most any man. I'd sneak it out of there in a lunchbox in my hand. Now getting caught meant getting fired, but I figured I'd have it all by the time I retired. I'd have me a car worth at least $100,000. I'd get it one piece at a time, and it wouldn't cost me a dime. You'll know it's me when I come through your town. I'm gonna ride around in style, I'm gonna drive everybody wild, 'cause I'll have the only one there is around. So the very next day when I punched in with my big lunchbox with help from my friend, I left that day with a lunchbox full of gear. I've never considered myself a thief, but GM wouldn't miss just one little piece, especially if I strung it out over several years.
Hi, I'm Mike Copeland. I'm the owner of Arrington Performance. We're located in Brighton, Michigan. This is one of our newest engine packages we're working on. Everybody wants more horsepower, so this is a step in that direction. This is a 426 cubic inch Gen 3 Hemi. All of the best parts inside, special made for us, Weisco pistons, Weisco rods. This one actually has a K1 crank in it, which has been all updated. Everything's all balanced and blueprinted, the best of everything. This has Titech heads on it. This is a special race head version that they make with a larger exhaust valve and a larger exhaust port. This is a Magnuson 2650 supercharger. When you max this package out, it'll make between 1450 and 1500 horsepower. It's still a hydraulic roller camshaft. You can drive this thing. It's going in a 69 Dart that we're building that we're gonna street drive some and then take around to various tracks and events and see if we can run in the sevens with it.
We're here at Autorama 2019. We've got some of our gauges on display. Anything from a 2 and 16th all the way up to 5-inch dual quad tech and speedo combinations. We have mechanical, we have short sweep electric, we have stepper motor gauges. On the left-hand side, the, see here, Cobalt and C2 series, and through dial LED illumination like the GS and NV series. Our newest series is our Chrono. I'm going to walk over here, pan the camera, please. Chrono is 360 degree resolution on the dial, and these are probably the most prestigious dials that we have ever created. If you were to take the gauge and roll it on its side, cut it in half, you'd see the dial actually has a physical contour.
Tack it up, buddy, gonna shut you down. It happened on the strip where the road is wide. Two cool shorts standing side by side. Yeah, my fuel injected Stingray in a 413. Revving up our engines and it sounds real mean.
Tack it up, buddy, gonna shut you down.
Declining numbers at an even rate. At the count of one, we both accelerate. My Stingray is light, the slicks are starting to spin. But the 413's really digging in.
Gotta be cool now, power shift, here we go. Superstar Dodge is whining out in low. My pressure plate's burning, that machine's too much.
Hey, good morning all. We're down here at the opening of the 67th annual Autorama. You're at the Masterworks booth here. We've got a couple of Corvettes that we've been playing with on display here, as well as this fabulous 58 Buick Caballero. Most of us don't even know what a Caballero is, but if you think back into the late 50s, all the divisions had a station wagon, except for Cadillac, and Chevy and Pontiac had the Nomad, the Safari, and Buick and Oldsmobile made custom four-door hardtop wagons. The Caballero was the Buick, and the Holiday Fiesta was the Oldsmobile. And this car here probably distinguishes itself by being the car with the most adornment of any car ever produced in the world. There's more chrome and stainless and moldings on this car than any other car you'll ever find. Joe found this car here, abandoned in New Mexico, and it was given to him for free. and he did this remarkable restoration. We had this car on the rotisserie and did the paintwork for him, and he did the rest of the assembly himself. You know, a real labor of love. It's been a four-year endeavor, but you can see what a spectacular car it turned out to be. So come on down. It's a great show, a lot of good stuff to see, both upstairs and downstairs. And a lot of crazy people that have inhaled too much carbon monoxide in their life.
The car is a 1958 Buick Caballero. I think you already heard it was painted by Masterworks in Madison Heights. I think they did a super job on all the panel fitment and body and paint work. The rest of it's pretty much me on assembly, and a friend of mine did the interior with me. The two of us did the interior. I've had the car since August of 2014, so it's been about a 4.5 year process. It's one of 4,450 hardtop Caballero estate wagons, which meant it got the custom up-level trim and the high-performance, high-compression engine. Haven't got to driven it much further than from the trailer to the spot, so I'm looking forward to having some fun with it this summer.
My baby drives a Buick. My baby drives a Buick. Well, you think that you got trouble and you think that you went through it. Well, you ain't saying nothing till your baby drives a Buick.
Hi, Lily.
Hey, how are ya?
Good, how are you doing?
I'm doing pretty well.
Oh, well, tell me how the show is.
It's going pretty well. I've just been walking around, checked out WCC, got my ring cleaned.
All right.
Yeah, I took pictures of all the grade eights.
All right.
Have you gotten them yet?
Yeah.
Yeah, you did?
Yeah, I got them, I think, on video.
So, yeah, we had the student confrontation, and that was fun.
Good.
Yeah.
It's good.
All right.
Good seeing you.
That was good seeing you too. Oh, I'm so sorry.
Mustang Sally. Guess you better slow that Mustang down. Mustang.
So hi everyone, my name is Autumn Schwabe and I'm a junior at Northwood University. I'm studying automotive aftermarket business, so in my booth behind me you can obviously see we have a large display here at the Detroit Autorama for 2019. Behind me is my 1993 Fox Body Mustang that is a 5.0 supercharged and a quarter mile to go is about 1240s going at I want to say 112 miles per hour. My dad and I work on the car together, and I'm currently building another Fox Body. I'm super passionate about the automotive industry, and I've been an intern with Ford Performance for the last two summers. Thanks to Northwood University, I've had an awesome time interning with them. I got to learn all about the performance vehicles, performance parts, and travel around the country with the NASCAR group and do a lot of different things with them. So I definitely love Ford Performance, and I'm thankful for my school for giving me that opportunity.
Give Motor City Floors and Coatings a call. Four times stronger than epoxy, 15-year warranty, lifetime no fade warranty.
Hey little Cobra, don't you know you're gonna shut 'em down?
I took my Cobra down to the track, hit to the back of my Cadillac. Everyone was there just waiting for me. There were plenty of skin.
Alright, let's start. Latest vehicle here, it's a 1929 Ford Model A on a Shadowrod's chassis, built by staff and students at the Washington Community College. We're about halfway done with the build, so the outside looks really good, but we'll have it all finished up and run and drive in the summer. We'll bring it back to Autorama next year to get all the awards and accolades for the students.
Bob Lowing from Washington Community College. We're at the 2019 Autorama. What you have here in front of us is a car that we've been putting together here for about a year. It's about half finished. Going to try to get all the final details done here in the next probably two or three months. It's a 1929 Model A. A lot of modifications. Been chopped. Front end's been narrowed. And frame's been channeled. Has a modern blue off of a 2007 HHR. And it's got a lot of gold pearl in it, and something we have been doing with the students for quite a while, and looking forward to seeing it get done.
Spring little Cobra getting ready to strike. Spring little Cobra with all of your might. Spring little Cobra getting ready to strike. Spring little Cobra with all of your might. Hey little Cobra, don't you know you're gonna shut them down?
When the flag went down, you could hear the bubble burn. The stingray had me going into a turn. I hung the big ship and I got into high. And when I flew by the stingray, I waved bye-bye.
Spring little Cobra getting ready to strike. Spring little Cobra with all of your might. Spring little Cobra getting ready to strike. Spring little Cobra with all of your might. Hey little Cobra, don't you know you're gonna shut up?
Yeah, the Mustang.
All right, here's a few posters for you.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome. Enjoy the show.
Hi, everyone. This is Danny from Research. I'm down at Cobra Hall with the Pinstripers, the Mavens, and we're trying to raise money for the leader dog for the blind. So come on down and check the art out.
I'd go downtown, buy a Mercury or two. I'm crazy about a Mercury. Lord, I'm crazy about a Mercury. I'm gonna buy me a Mercury and cruise it up and down the road. Well, the girl I love, I stole her from a friend. He got lucky, stole her back again. She heard he had a Mercury. Lord, she's...
Hello? Beyond Metal Artwork.
Hello. Welcome. Are you videoing just because? Get a close-up of that.
That is cool.
Oh, she's crazy about a Mercury. I'm gonna buy me a Mercury and cruise it up and down the road. Oh, let's go.
Go down in the basement or come see us on Woodward. That's where we do our best work. And this is all his original art stuff. We do a limited amount. We never reprint. So it makes it unique.
Oh, nice.
So once something sells out, we'll never reprint it.
How you doing, sir? Just giving you a little run around on the 37 Chev. It's original coupe. 37, built in Canada, it's only been 200 miles away from where it's ever been built. It's now a gasser, it's got a Franklin rear end, Kirky bucket seats in it, made a Moon Eyes gas pedal for it, still got the original dash, tack drive, it was a 50s race car back in the day. All steel, last time it was painted was 1958. It has all the original paint and the door jams and rubbers and everything. Some of the interior stuff has obviously been redone. It all fell apart. It's got a brand new floor, front to back in the car. 350, dual quad, Eldebrock, Trixer manifold with a set of vacuum secondary pollies. It's gonna be getting a Crashbox Liberty Prepared Super T10 transmission in it with a V-gate shifter, just like back in the day. And it's all steel, everything on it, not a fiberglass part on this
car.
An old pickup truck parked in a field, faded old paint on American steel. Rusted iron frame, sinking in the weeds. Do my
teenage eyes, it was a driving dream. Grandpa Jim towed it up, got under the hood, kicked over the engine like he said he would. She wasn't real pretty, she wasn't real fast, she was all I needed, all we had.
Model A coupe special and Raleigh chassis and a 350 Chevy engine. That's about all I can tell you about it.
Automatic or?
Yeah, 350 Chevy automatic.
Hi, how are you guys doing out there and wherever the land is that you are watching this video from? I'm Donnie from Throttle Gals and I'm letting my other head chick in charge, Trish, clean my car. Actually, she's doing a product review for some Jack's Wax products. And we're getting pine sap off of my favorite car, my 59 Chevy Custom. And hope you guys enjoy the show. Enjoy my car.
She forgot all about the library like she told her old man now. And with the radio blasting goes cruising just as fast as she can now. And she'll have fun, fun, fun till her daddy takes a T-bird away.
Fun, fun, fun till her daddy takes a T-bird
well,
away.
Well, where is the standard cushion?
It's our honor and pleasure as we provide to you our tribute to the Blues Brothers.
See, we are on a mission from God.
Go surfing now, everybody's learning now. Come on and safari with me. Come on and safari.